Today we are going to calibrate SMC smart positioner IP8101 model. This one SMC smart positioner IP8101 model. And we have power cylinder, double acting power cylinder, and this one double acting positioner. So right now this is in auto mode. So we have to enter this parameter mode. Just press this one to manual mode. Manual mode. Press these two buttons, first one and third one, and this is calibration mode. The main parameter is 000. This is rotary. You can't change this setting. Always, this is factory setting, rotary. Second one, direction. You can change this forward or reverse direction. This is third one, split range operation. If you have any split range application, you can use this parameter. Fourth one, zero span setting, this parameter zero span setting, and fifth one, fully open or close, forcefully open or close setting. So basically this setting should be on always for proper close. So this is on, so if you need proper close, always you have to maintain this is on position. Changes any dead band, you can change in this parameter. Parameter 7, this is linear. So this is basically characteristic linear and equal percentage, quick opening. You can change. This is a linear actuator, so always put this one in linear position. This is PID, no need to change any PID settings. After auto calibration, automatically PID values are will generate, and according to the settings, it will no need to change any PID values. This is output 1. This is DI signal. This is DI signal 2. We have a DI signal output 1, output 2. If you want to use these DI signals, you can use through this analog output signal. In this one, you can change the signal increasing position or decreasing position. So right now in increasing position, no need to change. And this is calibration mode. In this mode, you can calibrate. We have a lot of this angle. You can check this angle of this positioner. So basically the angle should be minus 60 to plus 60 in between. Minus 60 to plus 60. You have to check this one. Just enter this one. Right now we are getting minus 39. Okay, this is within range. If in fully open position, it should be less than plus 60. For this one, you have to say, just loosen this one, lock nut, lock screw. Just turn down this one, auto manual button. So we are getting plus 42, so within range. So no need to do any adjustment, further adjustment. Try this one. This is a locking screw. Try this one. After that, come back to calibration parameter. So this angle, this is zero adjustment. If you have any problem in zero adjustment, zero settings, you can go through this zero adjustment. This auto calibration mode. Parameter C30. This is analog to digital calibration. This is 4 milliamps, 0. If you have to give 4 milliamps, enter this one. So analog to digital for 4 milliamps. This is span calibration, analog to digital calibration is 20 milliamps calibration. This is balancing. So automatically it will check the balancing of this positioner with this actuator. This is span adjustment. In this mode, you can adjust the span, the length of the travel, everything, auto adjustment. So right now we are going to do auto calibration. C30 curve, going to parameter, you have to first press these two buttons, go. Again, first press these buttons. प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा।
टेक टू
If we call good, we will display here, means the calibration is okay. Okay, call good means the calibration is okay. So, back, just press for 2 seconds, will go automatically back to, this is manual mode, and put this in auto mode. Right now you can check this one with milliamps. Now 4 milliamps, 0 position. 25% is 75% is 99% is 0.9 100% is okay, this one okay. So, the calibration is done. Thank you.